Now, it's not my job to teach you how to write Python scripts in MotionBuilder. I'm probably only going to make 2 videos and then quit, so you're going to have to pick up a lot of things through experience. First of all, let's be real. There aren't that many people writing MotionBuilder scripts and talking about it. Certainly, there are nowhere near as many resources for MotionBuilder as there are for Python scripting in Maya. MotionBuilder is just not as widely used, especially among students and amateurs. So, in fact, if you run into a hairy problem, you're probably not going to be able to Google it and get 1,000 forum threads and tutorials like you might for Maya. Relatively speaking, you're all alone out there. But there are some resources that you can use to help you figure out what you're doing. So let's talk about them now. As you learn to script in MotionBuilder, your best friend is going to be the official documentation. You should be able to find this under MotionBuilder SDK Help in the Help menu, but I've included some links below as well. This document is divided into 3 sections. At the top, you have some general information about working with the SDK, including a brief but helpful rundown of the architecture, as well as common tasks and areas of interest. Beneath that section, you have both C++ and Python reference. As we've touched on before, the Python API is a wrapper for the C++ one. There are a few things that you can do in C++ but not in Python, like creating motion capture devices. However, anything scriptable is identical between the C++ and Python APIs, aside from the obvious syntactical differences. Let's move on to the Python reference section. The page you'll be coming back to over and over again is the class list, and it's not a bad idea to bookmark this page. You might also prefer the class hierarchy since it organizes classes according to inheritance. At any rate, if you're not sure where to begin with a particular task, start here. Say you need to write a script that deals with characters. Well, the class for that is fbcharacter. We have a brief description of the class at the top of the page, which you'll only get for the major classes. Aside from those descriptions, the rest of the documentation is automatically generated from the source code by Doxygen. Now beneath the description, we have a list of samples in which this class is used or mentioned. Below that, we have an inheritance diagram. So we can see that a character is a type of constraint, which is a type of box, which is a type of component, which as it happens is a type of plug, and so on. Now the real meat and potatoes is this section right here. This gives us a list of methods, and then a list of properties for any instance of this class. These are very, very helpful. In the list of methods, you can see that the arguments are prefixed with a P. If you're curious, this is just an internal convention used to specify that a variable is a parameter. Some examples use L in the same way to indicate a local variable. You don't need to pay this any mind if you intend to follow your own conventions. Down in the property listing, you can see that most of these attributes have FB property types. FB property is its own template class with name subclasses for nearly every component class. What this basically means is that if you're working with an object that takes a reference to a character as a property, you'll be assigning an FB character as the value for an FB property character. If you don't quite understand the reasoning behind this, it's no big deal. To give you an example, let's say we have a character and we want to set its keying mode. That property is called keying mode, and it's technically an object of type FB property character keying mode. However, the value that we'll assign to that property will be of type FB character keying mode. We can find that class without the property in its name in the class list. And we can see here that FB character keying mode is an enumeration with 3 possible choices. So to set our character to use full body keying, we'd write something like this. Character.keyingMode equals FB character keying mode.kfb character keying full body. You can find out more about MotionBuilder's property system in the object model section of the documentation, and you'll find a brief explanation of the enumeration class that's used in Python from its page in the class hierarchy. The last important section of this documentation is the list of Python example scripts. These are included with MotionBuilder, so you can run them from the asset browser, or you can just paste them into a Python editor from the documentation. These samples are very helpful, especially because you can run them yourself and pick them apart interactively. This should be another go-to resource that you control F for whatever task you're trying to accomplish. It's also not a bad idea to peruse the examples up front so that you have an idea of the functionality that's at your disposal. Finally, there are a couple of resources that you can turn to from within Python itself. The documentation is great, but it's not 100% accurate, and it can't give you any runtime information. One marginally useful thing you can do from a Python editor in MotionBuilder is to call help for a class. You pass help a class, not an instance of a class, and it'll print a generic listing of all the methods and data for that class. Another useful Python feature is dir, that's D-I-R. When you call dir, you pass it an object, an instance of a class. It'll then return a list of all the variables of that object. When I'm poking around to try and figure out how a certain class works, I like to use a function like this, which takes advantage of dir and the reflexive nature of Python. It goes through the list of attributes returned by dir and filters the methods from the properties. Then it prints a summary of the object, including its source and destination connections, the names of all its available methods, and the name and current values of its properties. You could even pass in a substring to filter the results, which is handy if you're hunting for a certain property. So those are some of the resources that you can use, and hopefully I've pointed you in the right direction. Good luck.